There's some back here in the woods. Here lies the body of...
You might be able to make it and sharpen it up in photos.
I'm taking a video. Revolutionary War. Died in 1826. It's funny that those are still legible, you know, some of them. Revolutionary War. Caretakers here would try to take a little better care of, I don't know, not just cut grass. Isn't that their job to keep these tombstones?
I can't put them down because I don't know what to do with this, you know what I mean?
Oh no, I agree, but...
But I know what you're saying. This was once somebody. It's most unfortunate.
A lot of these people were very important to our history.
Yeah, they were. It should be revolutionary.
Yep, it is.
Yep, he had died in 1851, part of the 100th Division. Looks like I can't read it. Thank you.
in memory of Mary Moffett, who departed this life July, this 1886.
Yeah, that does look like it.
Why do I know that name, Moffett? Isn't that in a movie?
It's a common name.
Are these people just forgotten? No. Yeah. Holy. Look at that. Right.
Was it the woods when they were laid to rest?
Might have been an empty, open field.
Yeah, but these trees have been here a long time.
True.
It was the woods.
Heck, that's probably the best place you could be.
Yeah. Nobody disturbed it.
Right near the river. Yeah. I think I'd have to say, you know what, leave my tombstone alone. So we were down in there, all the way over in there, and that's where the graveyard is.
Yeah.
Things down there. We try to make a habit of cleaning them off and setting stuff back up the way it's supposed to be. Not touching the tombstones themselves, but flags or what have you.
They do take good care of the grounds.
That one's very buried.
Thank you.
beautiful. Died in 1884, 26 years old.